Truth-functional logic was discovered by the ancient Stoics. They realized that lurking just under the surface of language is a rich logical architecture. It begins with declarative sentences. Only declarative sentences can be true or false. Shut the door! Can't be true or false. It's just a command. What time is it? Can't be true or false. It's just a question. So declarative sentences are special. They put forward a claim, and that claim has a truth value. That's just a fancy way of saying that every claim is either true or false. For instance, the manatee is the world's largest herbivore, has a truth value of true, but the manatee is the world's largest gangster, has a truth value of false. By the way, get used to these T's and F's. We're going to use them a lot. The sentences I just gave are simple. They cannot be broken down into a smaller unit of language and still have a truth value. The manatee is the world's largest... can't be true or false, because it doesn't even make sense. Same goes for... is the world's largest herbivore. Not true, not false, because not really a claim. In contrast, here is a compound sentence. It is made up of two simple sentences. The manatee is the world's largest herbivore, and the manatee can weigh up to 1,300 pounds. Each of these simple statements has a truth value, and in fact, they're both true. One quick clarification. In normal conversation, we'd probably just say, the manatee is the world's largest herbivore and can weigh up to 1,300 pounds. Now you might think, this doesn't count as a simple sentence, because it's not a complete claim. But that's not quite right. It is here, just broken up. The manatee can weigh up to 1,300 pounds. So there really are two claims here in a single sentence. Now here is what the Stoics discovered. The truth value of the compound sentence is a function of the truth values of the simple sentences within it. Put plainly, if you know whether the parts of the sentence are true, you can figure out whether the whole sentence is true. It's easy to get caught up on the word function, but let's not overcomplicate it. A function is just a rule of inputs and outputs. Like this. You're familiar with the function of addition. Throw in a 2, throw in another 2. Those are the inputs. And the addition function will spit out a 4. That's the output. Multiplication is a function too. If we toss in, 1,000, and a 7. The multiplication function will produce an output of 7,000. That's right. That is a function, a rule that generates outputs based on the inputs. Now here's the genius of the Stoics. They realized that some words have logical clout. For instance, the word and. When two simple sentences are connected by the word and, then when the first simple sentence is true, and the second simple sentence is true, then the sentence as a whole is true. That's why the manatee is the world's largest herbivore, and the manatee can weigh up to 1,300 pounds, has the truth value of true, because its component sentences are each true. It's a function. But let's say we have an and compound sentence like this one, where one of the component sentences is true, and one is false. In that case, the truth function for and will spit out false, because the truth function for and requires that both inputs be true. If they're not, then the sentence as a whole will be false. So even though it's true that manatees are endangered, the sentence as a whole is false. We can summarize the truth function for and in a truth table. But first, a bit of vocabulary. An and sentence is called a conjunction, and each of its parts are called a conjunct. Let's write in H for herbivore. That stands for the manatee is the world's largest herbivore, the left conjunct. And let's write in W for weigh, as in the manatee can weigh up to 1,300 pounds. That's the right conjunct. Now, each of these conjuncts have a truth value of true. So according to the conjunction function, the sentence as a whole is true. But now, let E stand for manatees are endangered, and P stand for manatees are polka-dotted. Well, one is true, but the other is false. With these inputs, the conjunction function tells us that the sentence as a whole is false. Now we reach a crucial point, and it's this. The truth function for and has nothing to do with manatees. The Stoics didn't even know about manatees. The conjunction function works for any and sentence, no matter the content. So let's put a P here for the left conjunct, and it doesn't represent anything in particular. It's just a stand-in for whatever claim makes up this part of the conjunction. And the same goes for Q here. It's just the right-hand conjunct, whatever the exact claim may be. Now we can see the full conjunction function. We already said that a conjunction is true when each of its conjuncts are true, and false when one of them is false. Now, we just add that a conjunction is also false when both conjuncts are false. This table represents the truth function for conjunction. The only time a conjunction is true is when both conjuncts are true. In any other case, the conjunction is false. Conjunction is only one of many truth functions. We're just getting started here. But now you have a pretty good sense of what a truth function is. And that's important, because it's the fundamental idea behind an entire system of logic.